Be, where else would you be but right here in the Creating Faces studio with me? You know, we have multiple names. This is the Creating Faces channel in the How to Get Creative studio with Barb Owen of Barb Owen Designs. How's that? Let's make it complex, shall we? Hi, Di. Good to see you. Yeah. Anyway, we'll get it all down to where it's a little simpler for everybody, but for now, all you got to remember is Barb Owen, and search Barb Owen and you can surely come up with who I am. You can surely find me. So anyway, I'm so glad you're here. And those of you that are watching the recording, thank you for taking your time to watch. And yeah, let's get started. I have just the tiniest amount of show and tell. I mean, it'll take like 2 seconds. I'm not even going to get it all out. It's in the sack over here. Last night was book club at Soul Sentiments, and so while I was there, I had to get just one thing because I just feel obligated. I feel obligated. Yeah, so I got some new paints. So I got the new Dilutions paints. And there are 12 colors, and so I did get the 12 colors. No, Rain, there's no other place to be because it's Drama Free Friday in the right here. And we just like to, you know, we just like to have to suspend all the whatever and just have fun. And that's what we do. So anyway, I got Dilutions paint. Hi, AJ. Hi, Imelda. And in case any of you happen to be watching this recording for the, or this type of recording for the very first time, and you don't have any idea who I'm talking to, this is a live recording on Ustream.tv. That's where it's originally recorded. And I'm talking to my friends in the box, otherwise known as the Fibs, the friend in the box. And yeah, so that's who I'm responding to because there is a chat, a live chat going on. So, these are the paints that I got, and I did get the whole set because I thought, you know, might as well. I hate having parts of things, but sometimes that's what I have. Like, I have quite a few of the Distress inks, but I don't have all. I have some of the, I don't have any of the Distress, the sprays. I have some of the stains. I have a few of this and a few of that. Hi, Glenda. Come on in, have a seat, enjoy. And so yeah, we'll just see how they work. I have not cracked them open at all, so I have no idea what's gonna be, how they're gonna work, and I'm not gonna try them out on stream, I'll tell you that. See how pretty the drop paper's getting? Look, you see how pretty that is? Colors aren't showing quite as well as I'd like for them to, but anyway, yeah, so we'll put those off to the side till I have a little bit of a chance to play around with them and see, you know, kind of how they go. So AJ says she loves them except when they clump. Yeah, so is that a recurring, or does that seem to be an issue they're working on, or is that just, you know, I'm not really sure because I'm not too familiar with them yet. I will be, but I'm not yet. So one announcement. So let me go back here. One announcement before we get started. And that is that anybody that's a member of How to Get Creative, there is going to be the bonus class that I'm going to do on August the 15th, which is on a Saturday at 2 p.m. Eastern. Now, it will be recorded, so you guys will have access to it. But if you want to be part of the live class, it's at 2 p.m. Eastern time on August the 15th, which is Saturday. And so that bonus class is fabric paper using napkins, paper napkins. So anybody that joins HowToGetCreative.com at any level, there's 3 different levels and you can find out about that on the website. At any level, you'll get to participate in that class if you'd like to. So I will announce that again, and of course you'll get an email and so forth. Okay, so I wanted to show you something funny. I gotta figure out which window it is here. Hold on a second. That's the right one. Okay. I just thought I would show you something that was funny. So over on the website, this is the HowToGetCreative.com website. And over on the website, let me get my mouse out of the way. There is this tab up here called News. And if you click on News, there is a newspaper there. And if you want it, we showed you this a week or so ago, but just so you can see it again, this is free for anyone who'd like to have this. You can access it anytime online. If you'd like to subscribe to it, you can subscribe here and it'll come in your email inbox. So anyway, and you'll see the Twitter feed here and so forth. Anyway, I was looking at it this morning because I was just checking to make sure everything was functioning the way it was supposed to, and I came down here. And most of you know that I've been doing the Christmas in July series that I've done, right? And so I was scrolling down here, and so this is, I think her name is pronounced Didi Catrone, Jingle Hells Day 2. And so I thought what would be funny, I just clicked on it because I was curious, right? Thanks, Rain. So I clicked on it, I came over here, and I started reading. And I'm telling you, I started laughing. And so if any of you are inclined to be easily offended, you need to just like mute your computer for a little bit, mute the sound so you don't have to listen to it. But this is a riot. She says, "Hello, folks. So super excited to be doing a December daily this year in Jingle Hell's style." Christy Cologne, Jess Muddy, and myself have collaborated to bring you Jingle Hells, what December daily life is really like. Not yo mama's December daily. We know it's not all rainbows and puppy dog farts. So we're photoing the everyday bad hair, dirty laundry, late night wrapping, dog puke full of pine needles, December we really live. Sure, we have good days, but surely not 31 of them. Join our Facebook group here to play along, blah, blah, blah. Day one was a prompt from Chrissy, Black Friday. I'll get to that page ASAP. But here I'm sharing today's prompt, numerals in any form, minutes ticking by, cookies burned, socks lost, etc. So there's her page, okay? Scroll down a little bit. She says, my page is 16-1. Our first real Christmas, and we've already had a casualty at the hands of Gabe, my almost 3-year-old. A present with a hole. All I heard all day was, I can see something. Not awesome, but awesome. I thought that was really funny. Then she talks about what she was doing, you know, how she was doing the book and so forth and so on. Anyway, I just thought that was too good not to share. I thought that was a riot. So that's the other side of Christmas in July. Yeah, the other side of Christmas in July. Hi, Wendy. So, yeah. Okay. So here's what we're going to do today, because I think we're ready to crack-a-lack on, shall we? Let's crack-a-lack on. First of all, I'm going to show these to you. First of all, look at that pretty paper. Look at that pretty paper. Yeah, Janice, just go to howtogetcreative.com. Here, yeah, there is a link. Let me just pull it up for you. Sorry. I got it for you. Whoops. If I get the right window, we'll get the right link. Got to get the right thing here. Okay, as soon as I get in the right spot. Oh, I didn't open links yet, though. Hold on. Hold the fort. Okay, now let's try it. Okay. So, there's the link if you want to go. Or you can just simply go to howtogetcreative.com and click on the tab that says News. Okay? I know, isn't that pretty? Okay, so what I was going to show you are the little boxes that we're going to do. So here's one. Okay, so here's one box. These are just different examples and different sizes. So here's another one. And the decoration I don't have put on it, so I'm just going to hold it. Is Dee Dee here? I miss saying hi to Dee Dee. Hello, Dee Dee. It was fun watching you do the die cuts. Dee Dee is Inkwell on Ustream, and there are lots of streamers here today. So any of you that are, have a stream channel, a YouTube channel, a website, or whatever, I'm going to give you a few minutes here to just plug your own stuff. Pop it in the chat while we're chatting here for a minute. So please promote yourself if you have a website, Ustream channel, YouTube channel, whatever. And then everybody can click on the links as you wish. But that was fun watching Dee Dee this morning. I thought for a minute she might be headed for a meltdown, but she recovered. And Chance, the whole time, Chance, my Blue Point Siamese cat, is on the chair, and I'm busy. On Fridays, I'm busy. You know, I'm busy getting ready for stuff, and I'm just, you know, I'm busy. And Dee Dee was streaming, and he heard her, and all he could do was sit by me and pat my arm. He pats my arm. He crawls up my shoulder. He pats my face because he wants everything to stop. So that, sorry about the arm in the way, so that he can get on the table and settle himself and watch Inkwell. I'm telling you, it's just crazy. Yeah, Dawn's Craft Riot, Jean is Music Scrap without the A in the word scrap. These are Ustream channels. Dawn streams on Saturdays at 11, is it 11 or 12? Anyway, I don't remember. Somewhere Saturday, mid-morning. And Jean streams on Mondays. And Monday at 4 Eastern, I think. I may have, if I mess up the times, you guys correct me. And Dee Dee streams whenever we can bribe her into streaming. But usually on Monday. And Monday and some other days. And she streams early at the crack of dark 30. So anyway, so Chance was driving me crazy today because all he wanted to do was be on my lap and have his sole attention on his friend, on his girlfriend. So, okay, so here are the little boxes. Now, if you don't make it into a box, if you just do half the box, then it's just a little container, which is fun to use. And so you can put, you know, little goo-gahs in it, right? Now, so here's one. So this little decoration, we're going to talk about that in a little bit. Here's another one. Okay, so bigger embellishment on the top. Here's this one. This is the class from the member area this week on the doing the origami flowers. This one has the whole little bottom in the box. So it's a bona fide box. This one's a little bit tight. So there is that. Now, when my son was little and when our grandchildren were little, they really enjoyed having, we used to do these things where we would make puzzles for them, and we'd have them, you know, go here and look there and read a clue. My husband is a phenomenal way about doing poetry that rhymes. I can't do that to save my life, but he does. And so he would write these clues out, and so the clue within the clue was the, you'd have to go solve the clue to go find the next place where the next clue was, and eventually you'd find the gift. So usually that was whatever the big gift was for whoever was the recipient of the wretched puzzle of that particular year. And then, of course, the deal was you had to wrap it up in a million boxes, right? Hi, Jan. So this is sort of my spin on the little, you know, the puzzle thing, and this would be the puzzle, you know, at the end of the trail. So within that, there is another little box. And then, don't you know, within that box, there's another little box. So we've got boxes galore happening here. And so we have one box, Then we got two boxes, and then this is the third box. And of course, there's no little gift in it because it's just a little, box. So I thought it would be fun to play around with those. And before we get to the folding of the box, we're gonna play with some paper ideas. Okay, Vicki, see you later. Thanks for coming by. So there's our little boxes, and you can of course play around with the measurements and so forth. These are done, these three right here are done out of text paper, okay? Copy paper from your printer. These two are done with the mixed media paper from the Canson Mixed Media Journal. So you can do them. They're more sturdy because this is a 98 pound paper. And the paper that these are made from is a 20-pound paper. So, you know, there's a big difference in the sturdiness of the little box or the container. So you kind of have to experiment and play around with that. All right, so let's do some paper. So as I said, this is just plain old copy paper. And I'm going to get out of the picture here so we can just concentrate on what's going on. And there's plenty of doodle stuff on here, so you just sort of have to ignore that. So what I'm going to work with is craft paints and school glue, because this is the time of year when you can get the school supplies are everywhere and they're cheap. And so this is just glue all, Elmer's plain old cheapo glue all. And you can do all kinds of fun stuff with it besides glue things together. You do need to make sure when you do this that the glue boogers on the tip are not in there. The other thing we're going to use is a scraper, and you can use a credit card or you can use these, which are actually for doing body work on cars. And this comes, usually they come in a set of three, I believe. So they come like this. They come in a set of three. And these are a nice set of scrapers for different things. And you can use a credit card, a recycled credit card. And then all I'm going to use is craft paint. You can do lots of different kinds of paint, but I'm going to use craft paints. I've been playing around with these. This one was on clearance for 99 cents, which is nice. You never know when you're going to find something that they're doing on clearance, which means is the color gone for good or what's the deal. But anyway, I've been playing with these neons from Americana, and I really like these. They're fluorescent neon colors. I really like these and have been having a really good time. And they're a nice, you can see a little experiment down here on my drop paper. They're just they're good coverage of color, because I have some other brands, which I don't know, Anita's or CraftSmart or something. It was a less expensive brand. Not that these are expensive, but an even less expensive brand, and they don't cover anything. And I've tried lots of different neons, and you know, I'm on the quest to get the perfect neon paint. This might be it. The Americana might be it. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the glue. And this is just to make the paper to fold the little box out of. But, you know, why not do your own, right? So I'm just going to scribble as I squeeze the bottle. I'm just scribbling. And we'll do several of these. Okay, and then just close your glue bottle up and get the glue off of it, because it will clog up the end of your bottle. And you don't want that happening, because that will make the stream of glue not come out the way you want it, okay? So then take one of your scrapers. It doesn't matter which one it was and which one it is. I'm going to use the little one. And you can do one color, you can do two colors, you can do whatever you want. And I'm just going to squirt it on the edge of the scraper. Like that. And I'm going to use orange. So these are the neon colors that I'm using, or the fluorescent colors. I don't know if they actually glow in the dark. I didn't try that. Okay, so I just have some couple of colors of paint on there. And then turn it over, lay it down at an angle, and just scrape right across your wet glue, which seems like that would just be ridiculous to do. However, the glue resists the paint, okay? And down here where I don't have much, I'm gonna just put a little bit more. You really need to give it a one shot deal. Now I got a Muppet hair stuck in it. You really wanna do a one shot time across the paper, because if you do a multiple pulls across the paper, it doesn't work very well. It will start filling in where the glue is resisting. Okay, and so at that point, you're done with that. Set it off to the side. Just set it off to the side, let it dry. Now, if you got glue and paint and all that stuff on the drop paper, like I do here, you gotta do one of two things. You either need to spread it out, or better yet, get your glue gun out, or your glue gun. Goodness, listen to me, heat gun. And just dry that up. Otherwise, it will stick. Your next piece of paper is gonna stick to this. So, yeah, it's a lot of fun. I mean, this is certainly not a new technique that I invented or anything else, believe me. But every so often I get it out and I play around with it and I go, oh yeah, I forgot how much fun this is, you know? So just get your drop paper dry so that your next layer of paper, if you move on and do more papers, it doesn't want to stick to your drop paper. Okay, so let's go to the next one. So this is, again, this is just 20 pound copy paper. And we're going to go back. So I'm just using the glue all. The glue all seems to me to work the best because it's the cheapest thing, and it flows out of the bottle really well. I'm sure that you could do it with other things. So I'm gonna do another design. And hopefully you can see this. I think you can, even though it's white on white. And you can do it on whatever kind of paper that you want, that's for sure. You know, it'll work on anything. It'll work on cardstock. But the trick is, you know, put your design on, work pretty quickly so that, you know, you get it on there. You're not dilly-dallying around. And then choose your colors of whatever paint you want to use. So this time I'm going to use peony pink. This is Americana also. So I'm going to give it a good shake, and maybe we'll use sea breeze. So this time let's just do half and half on the scraper. There's not a reason that you have to do it on the scraper, but I find that that's what works for me. That's what works the best. To put the paint right on the scraper, and it's a nice little bead of paint. Okay, so it's a nice little bead of paint going across the scraper. Then turn it over and get your bearings on your paper and pull. And when it runs out of paint like it did here, you got to reload. Usually, honestly, I reload after every pull, but, and it truly doesn't matter. Now I'm breaking my rule and pulling back over it. It doesn't matter if it's totally perfect. So I'm just trying to spread out some of the thick paint. Okay. So there's that one. And down here where I don't have much paint going on, I may just come down because I got paint left on my scraper and just, you know, kind of put some down there. But you can't go over it very much, because if you do, you're going to lose all of the resist from the glue. So I'm going to move it out of the way. I'm going to let that one dry. So I'm just setting these over to the side as we play around with making papers. So again, if you've got drop paper down here, make sure that you spread out your paper and glue that you might have accumulated, and then dry it so you don't stick to the next one. You just got a gallon of glue all? Well, you will be having some fun, Lynn. So I'm just drying this so that, because the first time I did this, I was like, why is my paper sticking to my drop paper? Well, because I had wet stuff going on underneath here. That's why. Like, didn't take a rocket scientist to figure that out, right? This is a little bit like using your jelly plate. You can't really predict the outcome, but it's really fun. Yeah, the last combo of colors is pretty cool. It was peony pink and sea breeze. Okay, let's turn it and go this way, do something different. You can write words with it, because the words show up the way that you write them. In other words, you're not having to write backwards. Okay, so I'll show you what I mean. So let's do... They don't come out completely legibly. And that's okay, right? Okay, so I'm just writing some words, and then I might put a few little dots and squiggles here and there, just so I have stuff pretty much filling the paper. Okay, so that's what I have. So I've written words all over the page. Hi, Tam. And so let's go to, this is Martha Stewart Multi-Surface Satin. I had never worked with this paint before. And so I got some of this the other day because they were running it on sale where I happened to be. And so I picked up a couple of bottles of it because I just wanted to see how it would work. And actually, I'm pleasantly surprised. It has a beautiful finish and feel on this copy paper. Okay, so I got paint. All right, get your bearings on your paper and pull. All right, let me see if I can get one more pull across. Okay, might even be able to get one more. I don't know. I got the whole sheet. Look at that. That's pretty cool. Got the whole sheet. This has got a lot of thick right there. I'm gonna spread that just a teeny bit. Okay, let's put this excess paint on the drop sheet. All right, so I'm gonna show this to you really close, and let's see if you can see the words. Okay, up here it says joy. And then over here it says, maybe you can read the word hope. Right there, trying to get the light off the reflection, hope. And then let's see, right here it says create. Under here it says inspire. And over here, I just wrote it stuff in different directions. Over here, it says B. And right here that you can't read very well, it says happy. So you can write words. And then pull, you know. It just gives you a different kind of design, because some people don't have, they're not, it's like when you go, it comes to the thing of make up a design and put it on the paper, they're like, draw a blank, you know. So that is, hey Judy. And so that is something that you can do, you know, if you don't know what else to do, write words on it, okay? So that is another thing you can do. So then you need to set it aside, and it's kind of like jelly plate printing in that you end up with just a whole lot of sheets of paper quickly that have to dry somewhere, so you end up with them all over everywhere waiting to dry. So let's dry the drop paper, make sure we don't have stuff sticking. I had not used any of the Martha Stewart paint, and you can't imagine truly how beautiful it feels on this text paper. Now you have to put paint on this copy paper. It's because it's very thin. You have to put paint on it or something to thicken it up in order to get it, you know, to do very well for these little boxes. Okay, so let's do another one. So we'll do a couple more glue resist pages. And how about this time, let's just do lines. So I'm gonna just turn the paper so I've got a little better angle here. So we're just going to do stripes, and then we'll play with it. You could do Zentangle designs, you know, if you're fast enough with your glue bottle, because you want the glue to stay wet. And this stuff starts drying pretty quickly. My lines, my stripes, of course, are not going to be particularly straight. Maybe we'll do a little plaid kind of thing happening. Okay, so we got our glue down. And, I don't know, what color do we want to use this time? Let's see what colors I've got over here. Cranberry wine, and well, let's do the cranberry wine and the peony pink. See what we get. So I'm gonna do some different stripes on my scraper. Now if you do it on the bigger scraper, you're going to get more paint on it, right? And let's just do the long ways just to do it. Okay, I still got enough paint. Let's see if we can get another one. That looks pretty good, and I still have enough, maybe a little bit more here maybe. I'm going to put a little bit more paint on here, and just on part of it, because I don't have much to get. Oops, look at that. A splat right in the middle of my paper. A splat on my paper. You know, the thing you got to remember is that this is text paper, copy paper, and glue. So it kind of falls in the category of, oh, huh, look at that. Okay, so there is that one. Again, set it off to side. I've got quite a bit of paint over on this, so I'm going to scrape that off because I'm not going to be probably using that anyway. So I'm just going to scrape that off. Otherwise, that'll just take forever and a day to dry. So there we got Okay, that one. Find a new spot to dry. Make sure everything's spread out on your, but you can see how you can end up. Okay, hang on here a minute. I got something that popped up on my screen for some reason. I don't know why. Okay. Spread out the paint and then dry it to make sure that you have your drop paper. Hey, Jess. Hi, Rach. Nice to see everybody. Thanks for coming and hanging out today. And also keep your scraper cleaned off. We'll go to the bigger scraper just to see, you know, play around with that. Okay, so dry the drop paper, but you can see how your drop paper gets rapidly really pretty, especially if you're using different colors, right? Any of you that are familiar with Rach, who's in the chat, Rach0113, be sure you watch her YouTube videos, her YouTube channel. She's been, while she's off school, she's been putting up some great YouTube recordings. Okay, that's pretty dry. I know, it looks pretty, doesn't it? It's really fun to do. Okay, so let's do another one, shall we? That color combination was nice. Okay, so how about, I like that stripey thing. Let's do a little bit more of that. So we'll do some more stripes. You don't have to use craft paint to do this. You could do any other kind of paint that you want, but I don't think that it's worth the cost of using other paints. I think that this is a great thing to do with craft paint, because if you get started on it, you're going to want to do a bunch of it, you know? And so why not take advantage of using the inexpensive paints? And pick yourself up some glue this time of year, because it's inexpensive. School supplies are out, so it's inexpensive, and take advantage of that. Okay, so we've got a checkerboard kind of thing going on here. Now, if you run off the page like I did over here, onto your drop paper, spread the glue out, and you might want to give that just a real quick dry. You might want to give it a little shot of heat. This has got a pretty good application of glue on it, so it's gonna hold for us without drying too quickly. Give that a little shot of heat, otherwise your paper, when you start putting pressure on it, because it's just the cheap, you know, small, well, lightweight in terms of pounds, 20 pound. I don't know whether that relates to UK, but anyway. Okay, so I'm gonna pick my colors here. Let's go for another couple of colors. How about we'll do forest green, and I'm going to see if I've got citron handy. Let's see if I've got that, because I really like the citron green a lot. So this is citron green, and this one is forest green. So this time, let's use the big scraper. And because this is the big one that I'm using, I'm going to give myself more little, I don't want to do that one down there. I'm going to give myself, I've got more room to put the paint. Yes, I'll get it out in a minute. Okay, So there are my two colors of paint. Get your bearings on the paper and pull. Now, when I'm doing this, I don't know if you noticed, but I'm laying the scraper down. Okay, I'm laying it down. I'm not just pulling like this. You got to lay it down, otherwise the paint doesn't come off. Okay, so what happens here is that I was, and the paper gets rapidly very, what is the word? It gets very limp because it becomes wet. So I'm going to put just a little bit more paint on here, and I'm going to see if I can pull this across. When you pull the second time, you immediately start distorting the pattern, because the glue, it has its best resist in the first pull. If you pull back over it, you don't end up with the greatest result. Okay, so as the paper becomes wet, it becomes kind of vulnerable, you know, so there is that. Okay. All right, I'm going to move this over and let it dry. I was just reading the chat for a minute. Okay, and then clean off your scraper. Add to your drop paper. Make sure stuff gets really spread out, and this is just like a newsprint. It's packing paper that I'm using under here, and oh, CM, I don't remember your name, sorry, but welcome, I'm glad you're here. Clean off your scraper, whatever kind of scraper you're using, and then dry the paper. But anyway, this paper, as it gets more and more layers of paint on it, becomes sturdier and sturdier all the time, which is pretty cool. Hi, CB. Is CM another Carol? Carol, okay. We have a plethora of Carols. We have a plethora. All right, I have one more piece of paper out here. How many pieces do I have now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yeah, 6. Okay, so we're going to do one more piece of paper. Because why not? We can, just because we can. Carol with an E. Okay. We have lots of Carols. But only one Josie. Josie, that was a good name that you picked. Or someone picked for you. Okay, as I said about a billion times here, the reason I'm doing this is so that when I put the next paper on top of it, it doesn't, because it is copy paper, it's lightweight, just so it doesn't stick to my drop paper. And I forgot to put my invisible gloves on, but thankfully I have a Ranger craft scrubby, and so that will get this craft paint off my hands. Okay, we got one more. And so we're going to do one more design. Hey, Bunny, I haven't seen you for a while. Good to see you. Jan, how's Misty and Mr. Bear? How are they doing today? Okay, let's do just something, we'll combine a couple things that we've done on some of the other ones. Because why not? I never was good at frosting cakes or doing any fancy stuff like that, so this is a challenge to do this and actually get dots where I want them. And if your glue starts not coming out very well, then you need to stop and make sure that the tip of the glue bottle is not obstructed, because it will get clogged up, which this one is. And when that happens, you need to stop and clean it out. So shut the glue bottle so that the little thing will go up in there and clean out the tip. And then your glue will come out better. Okay, so there you go. We have a design. Rain, your doodle challenged? Oh no! Oh no! Then copy! When in doubt, copy. You don't have to be original with doodles. Copy somebody else's doodles. You know what I mean? Burn. Okay, we're gonna go back to Sea Breeze. And Citron. You do not have to use Americana colors. I tend to like the Americana paints a lot. I like Deco Arts or Ceram Coat, Delta Ceram Coat also. Okay, so we're gonna go, let's go long ways just because that way you guys can see a little bit better. So get your bearings and pull, which I didn't do a very good job up here, but you know, that's the way it goes sometimes. I'm gonna put a little more paint on the scraper. I find it's a little easier with the smaller scrapers, honestly. Okay, then we're going to come down here. Okay, and I'm going to turn it around the other way. I don't know if any of you guys are baseball fans. I talk about baseball periodically because I enjoy watching the Cardinals. And I get so tickled when they talk about the baseball players hitting the ball the other way. Like, I have still, as much baseball as I have watched over the last few years, I still have no idea what way the other way is. I know it's not this way, it's the other way. So anytime I say, turn it around and go the other way, that makes me think of baseball. I know, I digress. I don't know what way the other way is. I just know it's not this way. I'm sure someone will enlighten me. Okay, clean off the scraper. Yeah, Delta Ceram Coat is a really nice paint also. Okay, let me give this a shot. Just to make sure that I'm not gonna stick to the page. And then I'm gonna do the other side. Gonna paint the other side, but we're not going to. I know it is funny when somebody that's a baseball fanatic, which I'm not, I just enjoy watching it, because I like things that are in real time. I like them better than the things that are recorded, actually. So we're gonna paint the other side of the paper. For one thing, the paper as it's drying tends to curl, of course, toward the wet side. But it also thickens the paper. Yeah, folk art is a nice paint also. Yeah. I mean, really and truly, all the craft paints have their advantages. You know, even the store brands, Michael's has CraftSmart, and then there's Anita's, and I don't know if there are other ones as well, but those are the ones I can think of. And they all have their place, absolutely. Some of them have more pigment, some of them have more binder. You know. Okay, I think this is dry enough. I'm not going to stick to it. Let's go back to the driest one, which would be the first one. That's this one. And it's quite dry, so that's good. So it doesn't take very long for these to dry, which is nice. Josie says, hubby always tells me, no, your other left. See, that's like going the other way, right? No, it's not this way, it's the other way. I'm not great with north, south, east, and west, and so I invariably get myself in trouble when I start trying to tell my husband something was on the north side of something, because it's usually the south, not the north. So I just say, no, the other north. Okay, so I'm going to use the same colors. I don't have to, but I'm going to use the same colors that I did for this, which were the neons. And so I'm just going to dot. We're not going to use the glue this time. I'm just going to put some dots of paint on here. And, you know, if you don't get enough, you'll have to go back and put some more. And so, darn, you'll have to get out the paint again. But anyway, I'm just dotting on some colors. No rhyme, no reason. Just put some color on. Okay, and then I'm going to go back to the littlest of the three scrapers, and hopefully you'll be able to see this. I think this is, no, here's the little one. This is the littlest one. And then I'm just going to paint this. It's right, Dana. I'm a girl, left or right. Oh, that's funny. Okay, so I have dots of paint on here, right? So I'm going to use my scraper as a painting tool, and I'm going to doing one color, and then I'll go to the other color, and I'm just sort of doing a dabbing, scraping kind of motion. I don't know what you call this. I call it painting the paper. All right, so after I've got the paper or the paint kind of spread around, then I'm just going to start smooshing it. And if you get into this paint like this, you know, you're going to drag it up on the other side of your painty paper. So if you're really attached to the other side, you kind of need to be aware of that. And when you run out of paint, when there's no more to scrape and move, like I don't have any more down here, I'm going to have to add a little bit more. And so I tend to just kind of put it, you know, put the color, you know, wherever it seems like it wants to go. I don't know how to explain it. I don't know how to explain it, Lucy. I'll just do it. So all I'm after is to coat this. This is not going to show. But just in case I like this side better than the other side, I'm gonna make it pretty, you know? But the whole purpose of this is just get paint on this side of the paper and you know, that's the whole thing. And I don't want it just one solid color. I want it something that's kind of fun and interesting. And if I have some edges that aren't covered, that's fine. Okay, so it's really very, very thin. Let me show you here. Okay, can you see how dynamically hot pink and hot orange? Very, very neon. Okay, very, very neon. But it's very scrapey looking, you know, and so forth. Okay, so there you go. That's that. So this is the other side of that. So I'm gonna put that off to the side. And we'll go to the next one, which I don't know which one it might be. Maybe this one, I don't know. And this seems like it's totally dry. Let's dry the bottom. The drop paper just to make sure we don't stick to it. Thanks, Tam. But by doing the scraping and not using tons of paint, you don't end up you know, with it dries pretty quickly. But it does, there's enough that it thickens the paper a little bit. And that's what I'm after, is to give it some body. Okay, so here is this one. So this color combination was the peony pink and the cranberry wine. So as I said, it doesn't matter that it's the same colors or not, but you know, why not? Why not? So again, I'm just gonna put some dots. Now you can do this in all different kinds of ways. And I have a dauber here somewhere. If I can put my hand on it, we'll use that on the next one. Okay, so we got some pink peony. Or peony, depending on how you pronounce it. My dad, who was a florist, always said peony. So he would correct me if I said peony. It's kind of like poinsettia. One of my friends always called them poinsettias. Poinsettias. And I said, that's not how you say that. She goes, yes, I do. So again, just kind of dabble, you know, dab scrape some paint here and there, just kind of get it started. And I usually go for one color just because. Then go for the other color. And after you got everything kind of, you know, spread a little bit, then just start spreading the paint around. But by doing that dib dabble thing to begin with, it seems to keep it from turning all one color, which I like. My favorite show in the world started last night. I didn't even know. Project Runway. I really like Project Runway. I think it's a fun show to watch. I love watching some of them have their meltdowns, and I enjoy seeing what they come up with and the challenges and so forth. I really enjoy it. Anyway, it started last night, so I'm not much on a lot of the quote-unquote reality shows, but I really like Project Runway. Okie doke. Let's put a little bit more of this, just a little bit, and a little bit over here. Okay, and so there you go. Okay. Yeah, it started last night. I hadn't seen it either. Didn't know it was going to be on. Okay, so there's the back of that one. Hopefully you can see that. Yeah, I really like Project Runway. I always have from the time I started watching it, which I didn't start when it very first started, the series. But, you know, when it very first came on, I wasn't watching it. But anyway, I've watched it for the last few years. Okay, so there's that one. That's the back, or one side. That's the other side. But you can see how very limp the paper is, you know, so you got to be careful with it. It's very vulnerable when it gets this wet. Okay, so I'm putting it beside me on the chair. Hopefully no one, well, the cats are locked away, so we should be good there. All right. How about this one? That one's not dry at all. That one. This one with the words on it is fairly dry. Yet again, let's dry the drop paper a little bit. Clean off a little bit of paint off the scraper. Look at me multitasking. I'm drying and cleaning at the same time. Oh, Glenda's been watching it since day one. Yeah, that was a tough one, Corey. I remember that one too, the plus size challenge. Yeah, that was something. Okay, so let's go to this one. I'm going to see if I can find my spouncer dauber thing. Let me see if I can find it. If I can't, we'll use a piece of makeup sponge. Okay, this is the Martha Stewart paints. These satin Martha Stewart paints. I'm telling you, that is the nicest feel paint. It is delicious paint. I think I might have to get some more of that. I'm thinking I might. All right, I don't know where this bouncer is, so we're gonna go for I really want to find the spouncer. Hang on. If I can't find it, we'll do the makeup sponge. Let me look. I found the itty bitty spouncer. Here's the itty bitty spouncer. So we'll use that. Okay. So, we're going to do, I'm just going to do the same colors that I did on the other side. So, it was the two Martha Stewart colors that I have. And so, again, I'm just going to put some paint on. But we're going to do this side with this bouncer. So, just put on some dots of paint. Hi, JZ. We're talking about Project Runway. And paint. And glue. We're just yapping. Okay, so I have a little spouncer, I have some dots of paint. And I'm just gonna start painting. So once I get the blue kind of spounced around, I'm going to clean off the spouncer by just kind of adding some circles here and there. And if I have, you know, way too much blue, which it looks like I might, then I just kind of add some on my paper over here. Because that spouncer really gets a lot of paint in it. And then I'm going to go to the other color, which I clearly put out too much of these paints. And then I'm just going to kind of swirl them all together. So if you use less paint than I did, you'll have a more mottled appearance, as opposed to this one's going to coat. Go or turn or come up with some hybrid word by taking those two words and put together, which is easy to do for me. And just come up with your painty background. Just get paint on it, but it gives it a different look when you have the kind of swirly stuff going on as opposed to the scraped background. And your hands will get nice and painty because you got to kind of hang on to things, kind of help things along here. And as I said, none of this is going to show, but sometimes I like the back side of the paper better than the front side, so it gives me choices and it thickens up the paper. Of course, you could then go back on top of these and you could stencil on them, you could stamp on them, you could do all kinds of things. Okay, so there might be some paint boogers in there, but you just kind of brush them off and go, yep, there they go. Okay, clean out your little spouncer. This is a cheap, cheap spouncer. It's going cockeyed. It's going crooked. Like, oh well, I have others somewhere, but I don't know where. Okay, let's dry this a little bit. Hi, Erica. Any of you that are watching on the live broadcast and have not signed in, if you'd like to chat with the group, all it takes is to create an account, and that's free. You need to create a username and a password, and then you can chat with the group. Paula's here. Miss Paula is here. Okay, this one was really wet, so I'm gonna dry it. Hey, DJ said, I'm glad I'm not the only one. Hi, Sherry. Oh, is Paula here? Sorry, I thought you said Paula is here. See, that's what happens when you only kind of read the chat. I'm getting some lovely painty fingers happening. Hi, Jillian. Okay, and then we're going to turn it over. And I've only got three more sheets. Can you guys stand to see three more sheets painted? And then we're going to do boxes. We're going to fold some boxes. Okay, so these colors that I used on this, I think, was forest green and citron green, I believe. So well, maybe we'll spounce again, and maybe I won't put on so much paint. Let's see, shall we? We'll give it a try. Okay, Janet. Janet's here for the duration. All right. We've only been on for an hour. I've only been recording for an hour, so it's not bad. Not bad. Now my spouncer over here is got some lavender paint, was the last color I used. So this could be interesting. Could go horribly wrong. It's going a little bit muddy, but what are you doing, Sandy? My Sandy girl is in the studio with me today, and she lays right square in my way, of course, because that's what she does. And periodically she has to get up and turn herself around, and she lays right back down in usually the same position. She's pretty funny. She's a funny dog. I think Muppet's in the studio today too, the other dog. Okay, then we'll just bounce around. We just bounce ourselves around the paper. Now I'm doing the other side. That's right. It's kind of like hitting the baseball the other way. We don't know what it means, but that's what they say. I did one side, now I'm doing the other side. And if you run out of paint, you know, if the paint starts drying too much, then you're going to have to put on a little bit more. Okay, let's see if we got enough to go the distance now, shall we? My favorite baseball to watch is Little League. And it's getting close to time for them to do their big tournament. And I love watching Little League baseball, because those kids are little enough that they still, they take playing the game, for the most part, pretty seriously. but they're still little boys, and they'll hug each other, and they don't want to lose, and they'll cry, but the next thing you know, they're trading pins with each other and having fun together. So I love watching Little League, and some of those kids are incredible. Okay, so there's that one. So that one's all kind of colored up here and there. Okay, so we got that one done. Oop, don't let it stick to the other side. That's no good. That's no bueno. It'll stick to the other side. Okay, putting that out of the way. Let's come over here. This one's pretty dry. Let's dry the drop paper. It is a glue and paint technique. Yep, it is. And because I'm staying right here in this one spot because of the angle of the camera, this is getting quite a shot here. Yes, the glue is a resist. This is the glue resist part. The other side I'm just coloring with paint. Morning Glass is Dawn of Dawn's Craft Riot. And I think Dawn's a Canadian, aren't you, Dawn? Aren't you in Canada? We have quite a few Canadians here. And then some people from the UK. I don't know if Pablo's here. She's in Czech Republic. Hi, Colleen. Okay, I think everything's pretty dry here. Okay. So these two colors were the citron and the sea breeze. So we'll go back to the kind of scrapey kind of idea. And we'll just kind of do some scraping here and there. Okay, we got that. Let's go back to the little scraper, and this time let's just do this. Sometimes you just need to do something different. Besides, it's fast. It's not. Never mind. Never mind. I was going to just make an idiot out of myself. And I don't need to do that. Okay. So this is all scrapey. So scrape off the rest of the paint. And here is this one. So you can see that one. So it's just a scrapey thing. Okay. All right. And then we have one more piece of paper, which is this one. Whoops, I just got paint on the other side. That'll be all right. Whatever. Okay. Keep scraping down my drop paper. Just to spread the paint out so it doesn't take long to dry it. Yeah, Carol, CB, you knew where I was going, didn't you? I can tell by that LOL in the chat. You knew where I was headed. Okay, this seems pretty dry. Okay. When it gets dry, it reverts to its thin copy paper kind of way of being. So this is the peony pink and the sea breeze. So we'll do that on the back side. I'm just doing the same colors just so you get an idea of kind of how they look. Sorry, scooched off camera there. So if you use colors that work well together, this technique works nicely on the back of just kind of swirl and, you know, scrape and whatever. If you use colors that are too far apart on the color wheel, you will create mud. But you know, as other people have been saying lately, mud is a color too. Mud is a color too. Okay, so let's just scrape. So this one's going to come kind of a muckledy lavenderish kind of color, which, you know, that's okay. Mud's a color too, people. Mud is a color too. I can't remember who says that. I don't remember. Maybe one of you guys will remember. Okay, so I'm going to spread this out as thin as I possibly can so that it will dry pretty quickly. And, you know, there's a few little white spots around the edge, but that's okay. I'm not worrying about that. So here's this one with the peony pink and the sea breeze. That's exactly right, Carrie. That's exactly right. Okay, so that one's going to sit off to the side and dry. And one more drying of our drop paper. And then we should have a surface we can work on. Alright, so I'm done with the paint, so I'm going to close up the paints. So does anybody have any questions at this point while I'm just breathing for a moment? You like that one too, Rain? Cool. So I've been working with all my paint bottles open, which I tend to keep them closed so I don't have to get the pokey tool out just because I'm lazy that way. I have quite a buildup of paint on my fingernail at this point. So anybody got any questions? Doesn't appear that I'm seeing any questions in the chat. No questions. Okay. So what I'm going to do now, I think this is dry. I know this is another step, but you guys are going to like this, okay? You guys are going to like this. I'm going to go back to this one. Let me get out of the pen. I won't do this to all of them. I'll do it to some of them. And this is Basics Iridescent Medium. So this is Basics Iridescent Medium. And I have had this for like a whole really long time. I've had this in my stash of stuff and not really used it very much, not really knowing, you know, too much about what to do with it. And it has a wonderful effect on the paper. And the person that I saw really playing around with this was Kyla Givehand. The glue is totally wet when you do the paint technique. Yeah, it's totally wet. Sorry, I got glue and crap on my hand I was trying to pick off. And I have gone through at least half, maybe two-thirds of this container tube of iridescent medium. And so you can see how it looks on here, okay? And then I'm going to just start scraping it right on top of what we got going on here. Now, this may be difficult for you guys to see. I think I'll be able to catch it in the other camera when I show you on the other camera. But what I'm trying to do, it does not take much of this to coat the paper. But I'm going to coat the entire, my goal is to coat the entire surface of the paper. And it was in the One Page Wonders class where Kyla was using this quite a bit. And I've seen her use it on her Book in a Day series that she had online from a couple years ago. And I had never really played around with it. But I will tell you what, I really love the effect that it has over acrylic paint. Okay, so I'm not sure. You know, you guys that stream or that watch streams a lot understand how very difficult it is to catch things that are shiny because, okay, there you can see some of the shine. And truly, that's the only way that you can tell whether you've got it over the entire surface of the paper. Is you have to tip it and catch the light. But it just puts this really lovely sheen, and it truly is an iridescent sheen over the paper. And it adds one more layer of stuff that thickens the paper up a little bit, and it does change the color slightly. It makes it a little bit more milky in color. Okay, so we're gonna do that to most of, you know, I'll do it to several of the sheets. But once again, you gotta make sure that your drop paper is pretty dry. Otherwise, you'll cause things to stick to the drop paper, and we don't wanna do that. But then that makes another layer of goodness on your drop paper. So Imelda says she mixes this on the jelly plate with paint because she doesn't have PBOs. Good idea. Good idea. Yeah, I don't have any of the PBO paints either. Okay, so I just start with some globs and then I use the scraper and then I just start scraping it on. Now you can paint it on, you can dauber it on, you can do, you know, use a makeup sponge to put it on, you can do all kinds of things. I find that putting it on with the scraper, I don't use as much, you know, I get a nice even coat, because I mean, I am really scraping it back off, because I don't want it to dry with the iridescent medium being the main thing. I want the paint to be the main thing, and so I'm just after a coat of the iridescent medium, okay? And then, you know, like I said, you pretty much have to pick it up and look, you know, tip it and let it see if the light shows you the places where you might have missed. And sometimes if I miss a spot, I go, missed a spot. Bye, Dee Dee. Okay, so there is that one. And then again, if you put it on very thinly, it doesn't take very long to dry. I mean, it's dry almost immediately. Not quite, but close. Okay, and I'm only doing the side that has had the glue resist, what I'm considering lovingly as the right side of the two sides. Okay, so I'm cleaning off the scraper and dry it up. This is Liquitex. It's Liquitex Basics Iridescent Medium. Yeah. It's Liquitex Basics Iridescent Medium. Okay, that seems pretty dry. Okay, so we're going to do the same thing again. But I like what this does to the outcome of the paper. And all of this is El Cheapo 20-pound copy paper, okay? Corey, it's good to see you. Hope you feel better soon. Yeah, isn't it looking cool? So this part of it doesn't take very long at all. This is fast. You know, you just scrape it on. And I find it easiest to work toward the edges, kind of pulling from the center out. Turn it around. And if you need a little bit more, you know, don't hesitate, put a little bit more on. The nice part about it being in the tube is that you kind of control how much product you squirt out. If you get too much, then you just add it to your drop paper. And then pick it up and look at it and see. Pretty much looks like I got all the spots, okay? How about this one? Why not? I say, why not? I'm gonna do this for 7 more minutes. However many we get done in 7 minutes, that's how many we're gonna do. And then we're gonna make some boxes. And I don't know how many boxes we'll do, but we'll do a couple anyway. Okay, I think this is pretty dry, so let's go for it. Let's go for it. You could do this, of course, with your jelly plate. You know, you could jelly plate your, do printing on the jelly plate with the copy paper. But I just thought it would be fun to review an old standby technique using the glue resist, and that would be fun. And if you didn't want to do color your own papers, you could always use scrapbook paper or whatever your heart's content would demand. I had never done very much with this iridescent medium. I played around with it a little bit, but really not too much. And using it as a top coat, as a finish coat on paint is kind of a fun thing to do, you know? So there's that one that's coated. Okay, we got 5 minutes. Let's see what we can get done on this 5 minutes. You'd think that they would, Janice, but there's no raised texture to them. They only look like they're raised. You know, they are totally flat. Because the glue, when you pull across the glue, it squeegees it flat. So I don't think you're going to, it would seem like you should get texture from it, but you really, you know, I don't think you get much of anything. It's the visual texture, not actual texture. Now, everything you do on these, if you're going to fold these papers into these little box shapes, it's an origami kind of technique. If you're going to fold them into shapes, you need to keep the paper flat, so you don't want to put stuff on it that makes texture, like you don't want to do heat embossing, you know, things that will, unless it's really thin, you don't want to do texture paste and stuff like that. It's an illusion. That's right, Rain. It's just an illusion. Okay, so there's that one. See how fast this goes when you get to this point? This is fast. It's fast. And it's not half. It's fully fast. Okay. I know you guys are probably sick and tired of hearing the heat gun, but it's the how of it, as my son used to say. It's the how of it. Glaze and perfect pearls make faux iridescent medium. You know, I think that that might be a possibility, Jay-Zed. It's going to be thinner than what this stuff is, so there will be literally a textural difference, but, you know, I bet you'd get a very similar result. I bet you would. I'll tell you, our Jay-Zed's always thinking. She is always thinking. Coming up with ideas. And that is a great thing. Ideas are wonderful. Okay, then I'm going to turn it around and pull from the other direction. You guys need to get yourself a bottle of glue all, or look in your supplies. I bet you have some already. Or any other kind of the white glue. I haven't done this with the blue gel glue. It probably would work with that too. Okay, here's this one. Okay, so there we go. So this layer of putting on the iridescent medium kind of drives that glue layer back down a little bit, which is kind of fun. All right, clean off the scraper. One more shot. Judy needs to do something with her imperfect pearls. I'm laughing at rain. If you guys are watching the recording, you need to come over on Fridays at 2 p.m. Eastern, when you have a chance, if it works for you, and join the live chat and the live class, because there's some fun stuff that goes on in the chat. Yeah, Jay-Zed, you're always thinking and coming up with some cool stuff. Okay, this seems like it's pretty dry. Okay, so let's go back to one of the first sheets we have, and we're going to just shoot it with a little bit more heat. In an ideal situation, you would want to let this sit and dry absolutely to the point that it is completely bone dry. We're going to push the envelope a little bit here. Tam says she can find hidden relatives and animals in the drop paper. You know, that would not surprise me, Tam. That would not surprise me. That would not surprise me at all. We need to get out and do some more hidden relatives, shouldn't we? We should do that sometime. That was fun. I don't even know where my hidden relatives book is. It's somewhere here. Okay, so you want this really, absolutely, totally, 100%, and completely dry, which it's not, but we'll always wish it were. And I'm going to just put a board on top of this, like so, because it will just make it a little easier to see, I think. All right. So this paper, in theory, is 8.5 inches wide, correct? So we're going to cut it at 8.5 inches long to make a theoretical square. Now, I have decided that it doesn't matter just a whole heck of a lot if it's a 100% perfect square, but, you know, close enough is close enough. Bye, Jeannie. You see the word ack? You see the word ack on here? Don't look. Just don't look. Okay. So this is you decide at this point which side is the right side of your paper. Do we want this side or do we want this side? So just because you're not here and I am, I'm going to choose this side to be the right side, the outside of the box. And I'm going to put it face that side down. And I'm going to come over and I'm going to fold it in half, put the edges together and fold it in half. If you have a Teflon bone folder, this is a great place to use it. I don't have one of those, although I have some. I have the tab open in my computer waiting for me to order them. Turn it the other way, fold it edge to edge again, okay? So let's review, and I'll do this a couple of times. So we folded edge to edge and crease it. Open it, turn it, fold it edge to edge, crease it, okay? Ta-da, okay. Now you're gonna take each corner. There is a center point right in here. Let's just mark it. Now in real life, you don't do this. But for the purpose of you guys being able to see what I'm doing, that's where the two folds intersect. And you're gonna take the corner and you're gonna fold it into the middle. Increase it. Turn it, do the same thing. So you're gonna fold every single corner into the middle. Now, if this square is not 100% square, as it were, you're gonna end up with some little gappy things around on the corners, and still seems to work. Now, if the gap is too big, it's not gonna work very well. And it's a really good idea that when you're doing this, that you would stop and you would go clean your hands. Because if you've got glue on your hands and paint, it kind of makes everything stick to your hands and so forth. Okay, so in a perfect world, these are all gonna meet together right there in the middle, okay? The paper size needs to be square. So you have some latitude as to what size you pick. This one happens to be 8.5 by 8.5 inches. Just make it square. Then while it's all folded up, you're gonna take one fold like this and you're gonna bring that to the middle. So where all those little points have met, make sure your edges on the side, top and bottom, are even and crease that, okay? So I brought the edge over to the middle, just like that. Okay? Yep, that's what it was. Then I'm gonna rotate the whole thing because I am right-handed. So if you're left-handed, you're gonna be doing this the opposite, but right-handed, very right-handed, so I gotta turn it so I can fold the other side in to meet the middle. Okay? Now, the paper has thickened up remarkably with all these coats of stuff we've put on it, especially using that last coat of iridescent medium really thickens it up, which is really cool. Okay? Cootie catcher. Yeah, that's an old origami thing we all did when we were kids, or most of us did when we were kids. I'm sure it's gone by different names. Cootie catcher, candy dish, it has lots of names. Okay, so you see that? And we're gonna open those up. Keep all this folded. So we have two parallel folds. Turn it, and you're gonna repeat the same fold from the other two sides. So bring in the side to the middle and crease it. Then I rotate the whole paper around and do the same thing on the other side. So everything we've done has been very symmetrical, okay? Very, very symmetrical. And I'll do this again, as I said. I'm gonna open these up. And at this point, I'm gonna take two flaps and open the two flaps that are opposite each other, just like that. These two I'm gonna leave right in here. This little square, pardon me, this little square right here in the middle, that's the bottom of the box. So I'm gonna take this part right here and I'm gonna fold it over and just recrease the folds that are already there, just like that, and then open it back up. This is gonna become the one side of the box in a minute. flip it all the way around, and I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. Now, if you're watching the recording, just stop the recording and do the steps, because that's the best thing to do. All right, so there's the bottom of the box and the two sides. Now the magic happens, okay? This is the magic. You're going to fold the other side of the box, just fold it up and crease it right along the bottom, just like that. So we got two sides, and here comes the other side. Now when you fold this up, you end up with these little sticky-outy flange things on the side right here, these wings. Those have to poke inside like this. You poke them in, just like that. And when you poke them in, it just brings up that side, kind of like magic, but you gotta make sure that you poke it so that it folds up from the bottom. Okay, so it comes up like that. Do you see the box is forming? So those little pokey things poke into the middle. And then I like to turn the whole thing around because I find it easier to do the next step, which is to fold down. Now this is folding on folds that you've already put in there. Just fold right along that, and it tucks right down into the bottom. So that little triangle bit fills in that gap that was there. All right. This is the other side of the box. So the first thing I did was fold it up and just make sure that I have a nice crease for the bottom edge of the box. Now you see these sticky outy things when you pull up the side need to poke into the box. They need to poke inside the box, just like that. Pulls up, just like this. Pulls up. You're just folding on folds that you have just, you folded a minute ago. Nothing is new. You're using folds that you already made. So there's the inside. Turn it around and fold over on the fold that you had there, and the little flap tucks down inside. Okay? And there is your little box made from the paper that we did. There's the bottom. Okay? Like so. It was an 8.5 by 11 paper that I cut down to 8.5 by 8.5 square. Now, if you want to make sure that those flaps stay down, if you get yourself a little bit of tacky glue, then just lift up the flaps in there, and I put down just a little bit of glue and work your way around and just put a little bit of glue in there. I don't put very much, and I just kind of work around the little flappy bits. You don't need much. And then just make the little flaps. Make sure that they're in there nice and tight. And if I had not put a big black X in the middle of it down there, you wouldn't have had an issue seeing a big black X. That's why I said you don't do that in real life. And that covers the bottom of the box. Now, if you do a bunch of these, and I'll take questions here in just a minute, if you do a bunch of these, you'll end up with pieces that you have cut off. Okay? Let me get my iPad to cooperate with me. You'll end up with a bunch of pieces that you've cut off. And this piece that you originally cut off is not, it's not big enough for the bottom. That doesn't mean you can't use it, but it's not big enough for the bottom. So you might take another one that is big enough and cut yourself a square for the bottom and just glue it in there over all of that, and then you don't see that stuff, if that bothers you. Okay? It is magic. So let's do it again, because I'm sure that you need that a couple more times, right? So there is this one. And this glue, the glue spots in the bottom are visible. They should dry out and go away. You can see the glue spots there. So, yeah. Anyway, there's one half of the box. Or it could be just the part that you decide you want to use for, you know, putting little stuff in. I mean, you can organize stuff on your desk. You know, everybody ends up with crap on their desk, you know, and just little stuff like this. And not that this is crap. Jan sent me those. That was a bad thing to say. Sorry. I didn't mean that this was crap. I'm just talking about. Never mind. I'm going to just get myself in so much trouble. But, you know, if you have little stuff like this, little stuffage, you know, you can have, it makes a good little organization for little stuff like that. Okay? So, there you go. All right. So, let's do it again. Shall we? All right. Let's use this piece of paper. And it feels pretty dry. Okay, so we're gonna do size 8.5 by 11 piece of paper cut down to an 8.5 by 8.5 square again. So I'm gonna go to 8.5 on my paper trimmer. Line it up there as best you can so that everything's nice and square, and cut it, okay? And then you end up with some lovely pieces, bits and pieces of paper left. Okay, you ready? Yeah, they do make good drawer organizers. I just now figured out who you were, KC Care. That's Queen City Care. Just now figured out who you were. I'm slow. Okay, pretty side, decide which side is the right side of your box. I'm going to make this the outside of my box. Okay, bye Dawn. This is the outside. Put it down. Fold edge to edge, increase it. Okay, edge to edge. This little box is not my original idea either. I just decided to make it with paper that I wanted to make. I wanted to make the paper and then make the boxes. Okay, and then fold it edge to edge the other way, increase it the other direction. And in the middle, you will form that X, which I put a big black mark there a minute ago, which I'm not going to on this one. And then you take the corner and you fold it up to where the X forms from those two folds. Okay? And rotate it and do the same thing. Fold the corner in. Keep going. Fold the corner into the middle. Crease it. So you do that all the way around. And if everything is perfectly square, it will be a perfect thing with no gaps. And I almost always end up with a gap. I don't worry about it. Yeah, I care. All right, while it's folded like this, you're gonna take one side and you kind of have to help it because the paper's got some thickness to it by now with the paint. Fold it over to the middle. Make sure that the top and the bottom edges are together, okay? Straight and crease it. Turn it around. Do the same thing on the other side. So bring all this stuff in. Make sure everything's nice and lined up and straight and neat and tidy so you don't end up with a fold that crunches in, you know, pokes in and gets all ugly. Okay, so we got that. Open those two things up, turn it 90 degrees, and do the same thing for the two other sides. Now, I would recommend, before you go out and paint your paper and learn on your painted paper, I would recommend that you do something like this. Get yourself some scrap paper and do it on scrap paper. And make yourself a little note that says what size your square was that for this. And if you do it for a top and a bottom on your box, you're going to need two different sizes. So write on it what's the top, what's the bottom, and what was the paper that you used. And it's a really good idea to keep things like that. Okay, back to this. So I folded one side in. I need to fold the other side in. Again, make sure that you don't have any collapses here when you're folding. It needs to be nice and straight. Okay, like that. So we've got those squares, or the sides folded in. Now you open it up. Okay, open it up. lift up the top and lift up the bottom. Lift up the top and lift down, a pull down, whatever, the bottom. And then once more, take the side and fold it over and just recrease all the way down. You're not doing any new creases, you're just creasing the side in. It just helps the side to stand up a little bit better in a minute. Turn it around and do the same thing on the other side, okay? Up, fold it, that helps. All right, so there's the sides of the box. You can see the crease in the bottom right here, that's the other side of the bottom. So we're gonna pull that up, and I just find it helpful to just recrease that little bottom just a little bit. All right, pull the sides up, pull this part that's coming back here, pull it up, and as you do, just kind of let those side bits that are hanging out, let them go in like this, okay? And then I turn it all the way around because I just find it easier. And then I fold down the top right along the edge and then crease it. And that fold, that creates, that whole thing right there creates three sides of your box. Tam says she learned how to do this with used holiday cards a long time ago. It makes little tiny boxes that are good for ornaments. Use one side of the card for the pretty part and one side for the under part. Great idea. Great idea. Yeah, that's great. Okay, that's a cool idea, Tam. So we're going to do the same thing over here. I'm going to pull up the bottom, pull up the paper so I find the bottom of the box and just crease it on that bottom a little bit. Okay? All right, so as I pull that up, I'm going to use my index fingers to kind of poke in those little side flange pieces. You know, just kind of poke those in. Make sure that they're creasing on the creases that you made before, on the folds that you made before. And then I turn it around because it's easier. And then I bend that right down on the fold where it was folded and just crease it. Encourage it to go where it's supposed to go. Okay? And then you have your little box like that. All right, is this relatively clear to everybody? Right, relatively clear. There's the bottom, there's the side, there's another side, there's the side, and there's the bottom. So if you want to, you can put some glue in there to hold the little flaps. Otherwise, they're going to kind of want to move around. Okay, so there's that one. So now what we're going to do is we're going to make a bottom and a top. So let's do this one and this one. So we'll have these two work together because why not? Okay, so to make the biggest box that I showed you earlier that has the origami flower on it, to make this size box with this paper, I'm going to start out with 8.5 and 8.25. So that's what I'm going to use, is 8.5 and 8.25. So that means one of these I have to cut down. So we're going to do 8.5. We'll do 8.5 for this one. Okay, so 8.5 because it's already 8.5 one direction. So that's handy as socks on your feet. Okay, so this is my 8.5. I'm gonna use the other one and I'm gonna do it at 8.25 or a smidge less than 8.25. And you gotta turn it now and cut it again. So 8.25 or a smidge less. And you have a little strip that you can save or throw in the trash. And this should be a perfect square as well. And then you're gonna just fold the boxes again. Exactly the same way. This is gonna be my outside, okay? So it's on the outside. And here we go again. By the time you see this about two more times, I bet you'll have it down pat. Side to side. So you do edge to edge one long way, edge to turn it 90 degrees, go edge to edge the other direction. Fold, open it up, fold the corners into the middle intersection where those folds intersected right there. Crease it, turn it, do it again. And the less accurate that your original square is, the less accurate this is going to be, but I will tell you, it just seems to work. I mean, you can't be off by a ton, but, you know. Okay, turn it. Fold one side into the middle, making sure that the crease goes straight and without any little ugly little indents on the edge. Turn it, fold the other side in so it meets the original one or the first one. Okay. I open these back out. I find it easier to do it this way. Turn it 90 degrees and fold the side in. Like so. Turn it all the way around. Fold the other side in. And when you're doing this, especially if you've coated with the iridescent medium, it's amazing how this paper feels. It's just pretty incredible. Open it up. Open the top and the bottom flaps completely. Fold the side over and crease it all the way up and down. You're just doing that on folds that are already there. I just find that that just kind of helps all the way down. Okay, open it up. So there's the bottom and two sides of the box. We're going to fold up this end over here, or the other side of the box. Crease the bottom part. Okay. As you pull it back up now, you're going to use your index fingers to push those little flanges in, like so. Okay, so I've pushed them in. So it makes this little triangle on each side. Bye, Sharon. Turn it around. Fold it down. Same thing on the other side. Fold up the box on the other side that you have remaining. Crease it a little bit. Just kind of helps things go where they're supposed to go. Fold it up. Fold the flanges in like so. So we've got those flangey bits folding in. Turn it around. You don't have to do the turning it around. I just find it's easier for me. And crease everything so that your little triangles in the bottom go across the bottom and form the bottom of your little box. Okay? So there's one. So we're going to do the other side, the other square that we cut. This one was 8 1/4 minus a little bit, minus a smidgen. Okay, anybody have any questions while I'm doing this? Oh, good, Tam. Good to see you. Thanks for coming, hanging out with us. We're almost done. We're almost done. And I can see that the very first triangle I brought up, I didn't quite do a very good job, but you know what? Somehow they work. Somehow they still work. Okay. You probably bring this one up a little bit more, but... Okay. Fold in the side. And as I said, I would recommend that you do this on scrap paper that's unpainted to begin with, because the paint does change the creasing ability of the paper. It's a little more ornery because it's like I have paint on me, for gosh sakes. And now you expect me to do what? You've already messed me up. You've put paint all over me. And then you've smeared glue. And you've not only done that, you've adulterated me with iridescent medium. And now you want me to do what? So it kind of gets a little upset about the whole thing. That's why you have to be the boss of the paper. Open the flaps. fold the sides in, just recrease all this nonsense. But do you see why you don't get all hung up with the design and the paper? Because it, in the end, it doesn't really matter. Because you don't look at it and go, oh, but there's a little icky spot there. Okay, fold up, fold it up, fold the little, push in the little sides, fold on the folds that are there. I just like to turn it around, tuck the flap in, okay? Fold up the other side on, and you could glue the flaps as you go if you wanted, but I kind of wait till it's all done. Fold it up on that bottom, push in the sides, make sure everything's creasing on the folds where it was originally. Turn it around, fold it in, tuck everything in, make sure it all goes where it's supposed to go, just like so, and then you can glue it if you want. Yes, talking paper, that's right. Okay, now you have one that's bigger than the other. All right. So you put them together. And there you go. You have the bottom of your box that slips inside the top of your box. Then you can get flowers. You know, you can, this is just a little thing that I made. This was a Kaisercraft flower and another Kaisercraft flower. These are the silk leaves that I cut last week. From, I think it was last week. Yeah, from the little ornaments I did last week, I cut some more silk leaves out of that. That's a purchased ribbon rose. And I glued all those little bits together, and so that can be the decoration on the top of the box. You made it, Lynn? Good. This one's not as fancy. This is exactly the same as one of these little blooms. And I smeared Inca gold on it to color it so it was a little bit like this, because these do look kind of metallic like. This little bit in the center was a Martha Stewart clay, the air dry clay from Martha Stewart, that was pushed into a face mold and then let it dry. And then I painted it with Seabreeze paint, and then I smeared some Inca gold on top of it. And so then I glued that together, so that becomes my little flower face. I'll show it to you here. Okay, so you can see how that's reflective, just like the box is reflective. Okay. And then this one is the origami flower and the leaves from the class, for the member class this week. And inside is the bottom of the box, and you do want to have enough difference in size. And so you can see on this one I glued a little piece of paper in there over the bottom to cut, which covered up the triangles. Okay. All right, so to put your little stacking box, if you want to make it a stacking box, back together, I made this one, and I'll tell you the dimensions are the sizes of squares I started with. This little guy was 6.5 square, and then 6.25 square for the box that tucks inside. Okay, so this was 6.5, this was 6.25. It's just a little bit smaller, but it will slip in there. And the drier the paper is, the better this works, okay? Like these are a little, some of these are a little sticky, the ones we just made, because they're literally just made, all right? The shiny look is the Liquitex Basics Iridescent Medium is what I put. That was the last coat, from Liquitex Basics. Okay, so the next size box, which is this one, this is 7.5 and 7.25, or just do that 7.25, do just a little tiny bit less than 7.25, okay? It will make getting the box apart a little easier. So you can see the difference in the size, hopefully. Well, we'll just put them side by side. You can see it's just an itsy bit smaller. So this was a 7.5 inch square. This was a 7.25 inch square. All right, so this box, which was the 6.5 and 6.25, fits inside that one. The lid fits on that, just like so. Okay. This one, which is the outer box, this was 8.5 inches square, and this was 8.25 inches square. Again, make it a skidge smaller than 8.25. Put your next box in it and put the lid on it. Decorate the top of the box, and you've got a really fun little gift, right? Fun little gift. And then if you don't make lids, if you just make the boxes, then you just have little containers that you could have, you know, you could make yourself. Take this one apart. And you could have yourself a little caddy that you might, you know, use. You could stick them together. You could have a little caddy on your desk for little bits and pieces of carp that we collect, you know, little bitty paper scraps. Yeah, there's just always that stuff that you just don't know what to do with. At least it is on my table. And so you can have little organizers. You could make them all the same size. You know, these four are the same size or close to the same size, you know. And so you could have those, you know, as a little organizer. You could clip them together with fancy little paper clips or what have you, right? So that's what you do. Smidge is like a 1/16 of an inch. Yeah, it's like a 1/16 of an inch less than 1/4 of an inch. So, you know, you can come up with, you know, whatever it is to get the exact measurement, but it's just easier to say a smidge. As long as you're using the same measurement on your cutter to make the square, it's going to work. So there you go. This is the one that had, by the time you put three boxes together in this, this is very substantial. You know, it's copy paper, you know, it's copy paper. So, all right. Anybody have any questions? Because I think it's about time to get the sponsors, don't you? They get very distressed if they can't come out and see everybody. If you have any questions, pop them in the chat, and I'll go get the sponsors for a minute. We'll see what kind of ephemera they can share with my pretty drop paper, huh? Thanks, Carla. Thank you for coming. All right, let me get the sponsors. Are you coming out? Come on. Did you guys, any of you, follow me on Twitter at Barb Owen Designs? At Barb Owen Designs, in case no one understood what I just said. I barely understood it. I tweeted a picture yesterday of someone that threw away a perfectly good pair of sponsors. The cats are known as the sponsors, in case any of you don't might not know. And I have a bucket, a big plastic bucket over on the other side under the table, and I put old newspapers in it to use. Oh, come on. Yes, it's your turn. It's your turn. Yes, it's your turn, isn't it? Oh, my goodness. Put your big old self up here, shall we? Put your big old self up here. And so I said, somebody threw away a set of perfectly good sponsors, because it's exactly what it looked like. It looked like they were in the trash. Are you getting up here with me? Charlie can't make it. Charlie can't make it. Okay, watch this, you guys. Look at this. Now, some of you are going to get a little dizzy, I'm sure, but look. He just can't go any further. He made it that far, and that's as far as he could go. That was as far as he could go. Did you have a hard time in there? Were you having a hard time? All right. Well, thanks, everybody, for hanging out with us for the day, for the afternoon, on a Friday afternoon. And I really appreciate you coming and spending time with us. So those of you, again, that are members of HowToGetCreative.com, The members class is going to be on August the 15th at 2 p.m. Eastern. That's for anybody who has become a member at any level. And so, yeah, just to let you know about that. And don't forget about the newspaper. You can find that. That's a free gift. And you can find that over at HowToGetCreative.com and click on News. And you can see it online or you can subscribe to it. All right. We are going to go, aren't we? Are you done? Poor old Charlie just can't make it up here today. So Chance is going to get all the camera time. He's going to hog it all. All right. Thank you so much. And I'm going to stop the recording now. And so I will see you again next week.